How much?
200 each.
Yes.
Go ahead.
Yeah?
You speak English?
Yeah, English.
Okay, bye, man.
Cada un todo grupo. Is okay English?
English is okay.
Okay. Es de grado.
Description of the property. The military colonial building occupies a tenth of the territorial extension of about 20,000 square feet, which covers the area of the coast overlooking the sea. It had a square shape and straight walls. It's medieval, solid and heavy architecture with few gaps. It has a simple gateway to the main square. It has two crenellated towers of drums, which served as a defense to the inner door. At the corners, facing the sea, two watchtowers were rebuilt that possibly existed to protect it. It has a round pathway and a moat, whose bottom is made up of sharp coral rocks that are crossed by a wooden bridge, which was in the beginning a drawbridge. The main square is rectangular. The central tower is the main component of the whole structure, being circular and divided into three vessels covered by a semicircular arches. These vessels communicate with each other through openings framed by rocks. From the top of the building, the natural and cultural landscape that surrounds it can be seen. Mount Isabel de Torres, the bay, the port, and the sea. Goods found on the fort's premises during the archaeological research that preceded the restoration of the monument are displayed today in the nave of the central tower. Located nearby are such historic pieces as the lighthouse and the old port authority. It was in Puerto Plata where Juan Pablo Duarte, our independence father, was proclaimed the first president of the Dominican Republic on July 4th of 1844. But he could not hold office because in the capital, the prison cell at the Fort of San Felipe before sending him into exile. Also, Haitian soldiers who had been taken as prisoners were kept in this fort. Puerto Plata occupies an important place in Dominican history from the beginning, and we'll see why. The name of Isabel de Torres. In 1502, Governor Nicolás de Ovando, recognizing that Puerto Plata was the most important port of the north coast of the island, developed it, giving it a greater population. It served as a port of departure for all the gold and other products of the region and a port of entry for ships coming into the colony from Spain with goods and new settlers. The town received a coat of arms in 1508, which is described as on a white field of silver mount and on top an F and an I of gold, crowned with white and blue waves underneath. The letter F and I are the initials of King Ferdinand and Isabella. Being given a coat of arms meant that the town was already an important commercial center for the fact that being granted a coat of arms was tantamount to being in 1510, the Diocese of Concepción of La Vega was created. Puerto Plata stayed as its diocese. For several decades, the island of Hispaniola or Santo Domingo was the main Spanish colony in the Americas. But it started losing this rank because gold was scarce on the island. Many of its inhabitants left to conquer other newly discovered areas such as Cuba, Mexico, Panama, and Peru, where gold and silver abounded and became the places to which the Spanish gained preference. thus Puerto Plata, along with other cities on the island, became less important, witnessing a reduction in the arrival of Spanish ships, and from that point, the city began getting poorer. Puerto Plata and its surroundings then had years of decadence. Livestock in the main cattle were not only bred for their milk and meat, but also for their hides, which were very useful then because they were used to make saddles, furniture, shoes, boots. Puerto Plata were from the Netherlands, and they were mainly of the Protestant religion, which was the enemy of the official religion of the reign of Spain. This jeopardized the commercial and religious monopoly that Spain had imposed on its colonies in the Americas. The solution thought by the authorities was a drastic one, given that in 1606 they decided to destroy Puerto Plata completely, along with other cities in the north coast like Monte Cristi, Bahia, and Yaguana, and move its residents along with their cattle to the south distance of those who live in the region, as they saw their farms being destroyed, their only source of income that they had. The Puerto Plata region was left in complete abandonment.